Right. Well, it's good. It's been a while since I've uploaded anything because I've been a bit busy with my team and seeing my girlfriend and that, so just haven't really had time for anything. And we haven't really been scrimming that much. We've had a few changes, so got a nice another pack opening video while I talk shit as usual. We were in the Seeding Cup, as you all know, some of my old videos I've been talking about where we were. We pulled dominance again for top eight. They actually knocked us out the window bracket round three, if any of you remember. We took both the hard points off, which we'd lost last time. We really wanted to work on the hard points after losing the first time to them. And we won those by a mile, and we actually lost the game as we're strong at. It was really surreal. The kind of gay thing is as well, they updated the rule set a few days before our game, and they took CTF Express out and Plaza S&D, and no one wanted to scrimmage on those maps, and it was kind of shit because when you're playing against players like that, all it is you run into A-bomb and you shoot each other and someone wins, and there's no skill. And obviously the Express one's just a bit of a shit map. We lost that 3-0 I think, but they had 7 returns and we only had 2. I mean, they were really defensive and they just were really on the counter. They're a solid team, so we should have realised more. But yeah, we got knocked out at top 12 seed, so we've only got, well, when I say only, we've got 3,500 seeding points now, which is fucking sick to be honest, but I'm hoping that's enough for pool play. We were sure that top 8 would be more than enough, but as top 6 is concerned, I mean top 16 pool play, top 12 might not cut it. There's a lot of opinions of people who place just outside of top 12, top 16, deserve to be in that area. They just got unlucky online, because online gaming is pretty shit, as everyone is, so I'm hoping we get pool play. It'll be a massive plus for us. It means that if we play well, I mean, it means our first win at LAN will be for top 24, which you can't complain with, can you? You're not gonna do like a fucking, I don't even know, like a Bakesy and come last or whatever. I don't even know. Like, you're gonna complete them for top 24. You're right in there, and it also gives you a chance to play the top teams at LAN. And if you lose, you're not out. You just put in set in the bracket into in a lower point. So gives you a chance to scrim some of the best teams at LAN and gets you prepared for the actual event. So I'm really looking forward to it. We're all booked and everything. So it's like what, 19 days now, 18 days. I can't wait for it. My team are really excited because obviously we've been practicing and we really want to place where we're placing online, because a lot of people call us comp players, which is quite annoying, but hopefully we can prove the haters wrong and make a decent name for ourselves this game, because we're all good players individually and we all work well together. We did have a bit of a, I was saying I haven't been uploading as well because I was at my girlfriend's, but also Yolis, we had a few problems in the team which have been sorted now, but we ended up dropping Yolis, which we all kind of talked about and realised that we should have given him a better chance to improve. So we picked him up again, but obviously that put us back a day or two, and it was a bit weird between us all, but now it's all cool, it's all good. A lot of people said that we should have dropped him, and a lot of people said we shouldn't. It's mixed opinions, but personally he's been in our team for like 2 months and we've placed top 12 when no one thought we would, so it'd be stupid to just drop someone just because we think he might choke at LAN or he's causing arguments. But since he's come back in the team, it's been absolutely fine. The team's got on fine, so I'm just looking forward to LAN and kind of like nailing down that top 16 placement. So that's what we're aiming for. We really want it. We think we're capable, so can't see why we shouldn't. Another thing I want to talk about is iSeries. I've made a free agent for it, Fred. I'll post that in the link below. In the description, sorry, for iSeries. Basically, Hadzi can't go, and I don't think Purz wants to go now. Yolis said he would, but I doubt he will. That pretty much just leaves it to me. I really want to go. I've never been to an iSeries event, and I think it would be pretty sick to go. So if anyone who watches my videos or anything, I'd literally go with people with no arms and legs. I just want to play. I just want to get the experience of the event, see what it's like, get a feel for it. And it's a bit of practice just before you gel, playing on LAN. You can work out which guns and stuff. If any of you are keen, literally just let me know. Post a comment, get at me on Skype, give me a Twitter message, whatever you do these days. I don't even know. But just get in contact with me. The only thing I can say, like it will say my thread, I won't be scrimming with you unless it's like a day or two before the event. As I've got my team for everything else sorted, it's just this event that I won't be... Who the fuck is that? Sorry about that. Yeah, so it's just my team I'll be scrimming with, so just so you're aware of that. I actually just spent 30 quid on these points, and they had the special pack out, 350 FIFA points for a pack, and I shit you not, the best player I got was Shamal, who's like, I don't even know who he is. Fucking hell, that guy's Usain Bolt's cousin, what the fuck? That'll be worth some pee. Yeah, I got bought 5 packs, 350 points each. Best player I get, Shamal. That's packs that were 14 players with 3 rares, and I got dog shit. The game is fucking shit. I only actually do this just to kill time while I'm talking, otherwise it'd be really boring. Don't been playing much Call of Duty recently, so I haven't got any gameplays. And also, I've been struggling with my connection. It's been dropping a lot, so I haven't really been performing that well at recently in scrims. I want to know what, like, kind of people think predictions-wise. I'm just gonna give you a little prediction. Who I think might do quite well. I definitely think Curse are gonna be in that top 5 area without a doubt at LAN. Mac and Vapes are always on a free bar online, and they still manage to compete against top players. So at LAN, obviously they're gonna be. Oh, I don't even know, I don't even want to talk about that, they're just going to do damage. I definitely think Prophecy are going to win the event with that lineup now. They've got 3 weeks to grind out solidly, so there's no reason they shouldn't win the event. I mean, they've got the experience, the ability wise, it's all there. If they didn't win, it would be seen as a massive choke. I can't see TCM being in the top 5, I don't think they've got the potential. Dragons, I can see them top 5 because every event recently they've been always just outside the money, and I think this event's going to be their event. I think they'll be able to hit that top 5 space. I don't know really what their name's called. I think, is it Wigan Esports? It's like Horizon and Viz, Store and Bandit. I definitely think they're going to get around the top 12 mark. They're a really good team, and at LAN they play really well. So I think they're going to be like a surprise. Obviously, you've got the other teams like Horizon, Dignitas, EQ. I can definitely see EQ choking their placement. I mean, Robs is sick. I don't really know much about ANZ. Too Much is sick. Sneaky's like decent at LAN. But I can't see them getting a top 5 like they did at Reflex. It's not going to happen against the top teams. I think Abstract again, they'll be top 16, top 12. As long as Elixir E brings his route to LAN, he should be alright. I'm just kidding, Elixir E, you cunt. Other than that, the usual guess. I think Millennium, I think a lot of people are going to think they're just going to walk through it, that they're not. They're going to have to play a hell of a lot of games compared to the seeded teams. Someone could shock result, like Killerfish. I think they came top 32 in the scene tournament, so like most likely they'll be playing a team like Millennium earlier on, so I'm pretty sure one of them will get knocked into loser's bracket quite early. But I definitely think there's going to be a few upsets because of this online scene tournament. I see a lot of people tweeting about how annoyed they are and so and so. Oh, another team I definitely got a good feeling about is Fairlost team, with Ryan, H2K, Mats and Remedy. They're a sick team, and I definitely think they'll be hitting top 8. But it's a shame that they've only just picked up Ryan, because obviously Fairlost's been playing the game now since the start, and I think if they had been teaming for longer than what's left to LAN, they would be doing some real damage at LAN, like they'd be knocking out some big teams. But other than that, I haven't got much to talk about. It's standard, get on the grind for EGL, make a GB team. Obviously just to get S&D on point, because the more you play, the better you are at S&D. It's all about feeling the map and shit, so you get not many people scrimming either, so it's the best opportunity. It's the top tip, I think, if you looking to improve your S&D game, fuck the scrims. Focus on your hardpoint and scrim S&D when you can. You want to be making a GB team when people aren't scrimming, because it's the only way you're going to get real practice in. Playing one S&D map every best of seven or best of five is pretty pointless. It does nothing for your team, really. So if you're not practiced for S&D at LAN, then you may as well just not like consider yourself a loss, but what is it, like 25% of LAN now? It's like 50% hardpoint or something like that, or 60% hardpoint, 20%. Yeah, that's the one. 60% hardpoint, 20% S&D. It's quite a big chunk. If you can win your S&Ds and hardpoints, you're going to do really well at LAN, so got to focus on it. I think CTF is really shit on this game. The worst game I've ever played on any of the Call of Duties, just because it's so campy with score streaks. I'm really for score streaks, but when people are camping, the back of their flag, lying down, hiding in corners, it just ruins the game, it ruins the flow. And the maps are really big, so like, you've got no chance of doing things. It's really hard to get map control. There's so many places people can sneak through. It's not really that skillful. It seems a bit rushed and laggy. Not laggy, yeah. Rushed and like leggy, where everyone's just running around, don't really have any clue what they're doing. It's just random. So it would be nice to see CTF taken out, and maybe Demolition. Like, Demolition's a bit like, it's like S&D and headquarters kind of thing. Like, you know, you've got there's going to be so many gunfights, it's going to be much more intense. You can't really afford to camp on Demolition when you're on defence or attack, because you've got to go for it. So I can't see how that game mode hasn't been brought in, implemented. CTF is the biggest load of bullshit in the game, and I think it's going to be a downfall for some of the top teams at LAN when they're playing against some of the lesser teams. Say us, we're playing against Property on main stage, and we pull a flag and we go 1-0 up. We're not going to be rushing around, are we? We're going to camp. That's how Ainsley's team beat Dragons at EJ08. It just really encourages camping, so you know it should be taken out. I'm down to my last few packs now, and I don't even think I've had one player worth over 5 rand. I've just spent like 5,000 points, and you've seen me get no one. I think that's the best player I've had, Abarte. Bit of a joke. Yeah, I just want to definitely say one more thing as well. Like, yeah, we did keep your list. If any of you think it's a mistake, or you don't, just give it a comment. But we all feel like we made the right choice. It'd be silly to drop someone this close to the event. And who's staying in the Norbrex? We need to organise a night out on the last night. Or also the Harlem Shake. The official Harlem Shake's been announced on the EGL Facebook page. So make sure you all bring like fancy dress, whatever. I'm wearing my onesie and it's going to go mad. So it's going to be funny. You may as well do it for a laugh. Even though Harlem Shake's pretty shit now, it'd still be pretty cool to make our mark on it and be on YouTube and shit. Like, there's going to be like, how many of us? 400? I don't know. It'll be crazy. So definitely bring your Harlem Shake gear to LAN. Just open these last two packs for you. Anyway, I'm out. I hope you enjoyed this. Give me a comment, a like. Let your friends know. Subscribe, retweet, whatever. Do your business. You want more? Anyone wants a shout out? Want to do a dual commentary with me? Maybe play some Pink Slips? Whatever. I'll just show you my team. If you want to do a Pink Slips game, be a bit of banter and that. Recording the reaction and shit. Or if you want to even do like just some gameplays on Call of Duty, let me know and I'll try and sort it out for you if you need some recording done. I'm really shit editing, so if anyone can help me out with that, I'd really appreciate it. Like a Sony Vegas crack or whatever, if you can sort that out for me, I'd really appreciate it. So I'm just going to show you my team and then I'm out. So YouTube, I'll see you later. Wir setzen die Trends, denn bei uns klauen alle diese Schuhe.